Anthony Tapies was in his 60s. It was at the end of the 80s. He was interested in doing something with his artwork and with his collection. And he was also thinking about his legacy, so how he could, you know, pass it to his family and to Spain and to Barcelona as well. So he started to put together the idea of the foundation, which was, the idea was to have a collaboration with the city of Barcelona, the institutions, the Spanish government, and himself. So the idea was that he would put his collection together, so his work. So it's more than, I think, 600 pieces of paintings, and even more sculptures and drawings, prints, that he will put together and give to this foundation, and that it will complete over time, so till the moment of his death, that he will give every year some of his artwork to the collection. At the same moment, he decided to start a family company that he would give his own work. So actually, he as an artist kind of stopped to be, and he became one company. So his work was passed directly through this company, so this company was able to sell artwork. But what was also interesting is that his wife was involved, and then after a while his children were involved as well. So they became sort of a shareholders of Anthony Tapies and I Familia, which is the name of the company. So the idea is that now this company owns artworks as well. They own prints and drawing and sculpture, the same as the foundation. So what's interesting now is that the foundation and the family can work together. So the foundation has its own purpose, and the family has its own purpose as well. So the family can sell artwork and can participate in the work of the foundation. They can also put together exhibition, and they can represent the artist. The foundation does the same thing, but also the foundation has the possibility to put exhibition from other artists together, because they have a space, they have an interesting space, they also have a great library, so they have also the opportunity to offer library archives for the public and for the universities, for people working in research, investigation, curators. So we're trying more and more to work together now that we don't have Anthony Tapies with us, and we are passing to a new generation. So it's interesting for us to try to work together. And there's also a third entity that we don't talk much, but it's actually quite active, which is called the Tapies Commission, which actually work to certificate and authenticate the artworks. And we also work with the rights. So this is a third entity that has nothing to do with the foundation or the family company, but they all work together. So they are actually the same shareholders that are in Comisión Tapies and the one in the family, but the two entities are separate.
You're Tapies' daughter-in-law?
Yes.
How did you personally get involved, and what is your background, and how are other members of the family involved?
Okay. So my background, I've worked as an art teacher, I've worked as an art critic, as a curator before I met my husband. I actually met my husband on an art project, so we start to live together in Barcelona, and I start right away to get involved with his work, because I was already into the art world. So for me it was a huge opportunity to get involved into something that I found amazingly interesting. So I got very, very passionate with this work from the beginning. So it's now 14 years that I've been involved. Yeah, I've been involved with the family. Slower at the beginning, now it's very intense. So I'm full-time Anthony Tapies representative and fan as well. And yeah, so it's more or less that. The rest of the family, my husband Tony Tapies, is the main figure actually, because he is in the board of the foundation, he is the administrator of the family, he's also the administrator of the Comisión Tapies. So he's quite involved. He also has an art gallery, which is Galleria Tony Tapies. I work for Galleria Tony Tapies as well. So these are me and him. We are from the family, working together. And there's also his daughter, Teresa, which is younger. She's in her 30s, but she's quite involved now. She works with us. She works in the studio, and we're happy to see her grow in the work.
Was Anthony Tapies explicit about him wanting his family to be involved with his legacy?
I guess he hoped so. I guess I know that he once said to my husband that he was counting on him. And I think that, yeah, to me as well, I think that was something he really wanted. And also the fact that he built this company, I think that it was also the idea behind it that the company could pass to his children and grandchildren, you know, and stay alive and working. So yes, I think somehow he wanted everybody to be involved. But on the other side, it's very, very difficult not to, you know, because you are with this incredible body of work, and what do? You cannot just turn your head and think that there's nothing there. I mean, you have to be involved. And I think it's often the most difficult thing for a family, for an artist family, because you have this responsibility, even if you don't really want to, but it's there. So you have to manage, and you have to find your way through it. Exactly. And also you have to find a way to go to the next generation, which is something that is quite important. Also, Anthony Tapies had this attitude that he protected a lot of people. So when people work, like Anna Agusti, who was in charge of the Catalogue Raisonné, she was part of the family. You know, it's just taking people on board and making them feel safe and feel, you know, engaged, committed, involved. So I think, yeah, it would have been a strange idea to just take it out.
Do you feel it? There's a difference between you being the daughter-in-law, so not being a direct child, and the direct children?
Yeah, I think your question is interesting, because it's a big part of what I'm doing right now, which is trying to be some sort of a buffer, you know, which is the idea behind it is that when you are family, like direct family, you are emotionally involved, which makes it very difficult sometimes, and you have to make very difficult decisions, and they're not always very rational, because you are too involved in the work, and you have, you know, past, and you have like lots of things that are mixed together. So to have a clear view, it's sometimes very difficult. So I'm trying to have this view to make sure that they can be angry when they need to be angry, you know, they can be happy, they can be jealous, they can be, you know, but what's interesting is that they can have their own emotion, and we can still keep going and keep working. And by doing this kind of buffer also with the relation with the foundation, it's sometimes easier to find a way together. And to, you know, it's not putting the family apart, it's really putting emotions in their places and trying to live to be a little bit more rational and to bring a new perspective as well.
I would be really interested to learn more about your relationship to the work of Antonia Tapies and how maybe that has changed over the last 5 years, and tell me a bit about that.
Okay. Yeah, I think that I enter the work of Anthony Tapies I was very amazed by his paintings. I was very impressed, and now that I work with the paintings every day, I find new things every day, I have to say, and some paintings that I've seen many times, they have total new meaning, and they really give a lot over time. And this is something that I find very specific with this artist, is that the more you look at the painting, the more you discover. And I think it was a little bit mysterious, it was a little bit hermetic, and this is something that he liked. Never give you the whole picture right away. So it's good when you start looking at a painting and then you start to realize that the abstract painting that you thought you have is not an abstract painting, it's actually a body part, or it's actually, you know, an object or something, and it's very, very interesting. So I get more and more interest in the work that I thought that probably over time I would get tired, but actually it's the total opposite.
And concerning exhibitions, do you have a strategy there?
We are thinking about it. I mean, it was a little chaotic, as I said, we were a little bit going with the flow in the last 5 years, because we were working on the organization structure, you know, of everything. Now we start to think that yes, we need to work better on the strategy. So this is why we want to work better with the foundation. We have a big goal in 2023, which is the anniversary, the century anniversary of the birth of Antoni Tàpies. So for us it's important. We are working on the retrospective that we want to propose to important museums, and we think that this should be done, absolutely. So we have 5 years to work on this subject. So now we start building this team of curators and working with the foundation, us, the family, and some other people from Madrid and from outside of Spain, which is important for us. So.
Are there aspects of his work you would like to be reflected in a museum show which haven't been yet reflected in the past?
Oh yeah, oh, there are many things. There are, because Tàpies has been presented as some sort of an expressionist, abstract expressionist, post-war modern artist, and I think it's sad because we are losing a very, very important part of his work that happened after the 70s, even in the 70s and the 80s and the 90s. Which is the 70s were quite, it was quite associated with Arte Povera, which is something that we don't link together. So we were talking about that last week, the fact that Tàpies was very close to the Italian Arte Povera, which was important for him, but you can link the work very well together, and I think this is something that we should work on. And then as you move on, then you start seeing that his work, he worked a lot on body, on his own body, but other people's body, but also on his sexuality as he grew older, which is very, very interesting, because it's something that we don't really talk, you know, in art, which is we talk about sexuality, but in an erotic, nice way, you know, young bodies and everything. And his painting is not about that. It's about having a very cold look on himself and having a very cold look on his sexuality. And I think this is a very, very important subject. And it's a very, very difficult one that happened later in his life. And I think this is something that has never been explored.
What would be the one advice you would give an artist coming to you who is thinking about his future legacy,
yeah,
from your retrospective of working now with the legacy of Antonio Tàpies? Is there one learning where you say a living artist should really focus on that?
Yeah, I think to have your papers in order, I think this is very important, to make pictures of everything that you have, everything that you've produced, try to know where is the work, try to have good archives, you know, be well organized. Also, I know that artists, when they are young and they start to, you know, work and be famous and sell work, they tend to maybe sell a little quick, and sometimes they should think about it a little more, you know, what they want to keep as a legacy for the future. I think this is important as well.